Welcome to Pestivites from the National Pesticide Information Center at Oregon State University.
Hi, I'm Colton with the National Pesticide Information Center, here to talk with you about Spinosad. We'll talk about what it is, how it works, and its toxicity. Spinosad is a nerve toxin that is made by a soil microbe. It causes the insect's muscles to flex uncontrollably. They become paralyzed and die over the course of one or more days. Spinosad can be used to kill a variety of insects. It is found in over 80 pest control products. It is used on plants, in homes, in aquatic settings, or as a seed treatment. When spinosad lands on surfaces or in water, sunlight breaks it down quickly. Spinosad also is broken down by soil microbes, and this happens more quickly near the soil surface. Finally, spinosad does not move well from leaves to other parts of plants, through the soil towards groundwater, or into the air. Now that you know a little bit more about what spinosad is, let's discuss its toxicity to people. The risk of having a problem because of a pesticide depends on the toxicity of the chemical, how much we're exposed to, the way we are exposed, and how sensitive we are. Therefore, all pesticides have some level of risk. Spinosad can get into your body if you eat it, touch it, or breathe it in. Once inside your body, most of it is broken down and rapidly leaves. However, spinosad can irritate the eyes and skin. In long-term animal studies, spinosad did not lead to the development of cancer. But what about other long-term effects? Check out our fact sheet online or give us a call. These studies are interesting but harder to summarize quickly. Remember, pregnant women and other folks can always reduce their risk by reducing their exposure to any pesticide. Also, while children may be more sensitive to pesticides, there are no studies showing that children are especially sensitive to spinosad. Among wildlife, the toxicity of spinosad can vary greatly. Spinosad is low in toxicity to mammals and birds. In fish, it ranges from low to moderate toxicity. However, it is very highly toxic to bees and oysters. Finally, let's discuss some ways that you can keep your risk low. Because with every pesticide application, there is a level of risk to both you and the environment. Consider all of your options before you use a pesticide. These would be things like removing food, shelter, and water, and blocking entry points for pests. If you've decided to apply a product, always follow the label instructions. In the case of spraying plants in your garden, think about applying during calm weather and keeping others inside until the chemical has settled out of the air and dried on surfaces. For an indoor application, make sure that baits are absolutely inaccessible to children and pets. Thanks for watching. Remember, you can call us or check out our website to dig deeper.
Pestibites are brought to you by the National Pesticide Information Center, a cooperative agreement between Oregon State University and the Environmental Protection Agency.